My name is Patrick Runyon, and I live in Lincoln, Montana. And I have a skin condition on my nose. In 1977, started working in the construction industry. I seen a crane on the job site, so I said, that's what I want to do. I want to be a crane operator. I ended up working on all the casinos in Las Vegas. Operating a crane is not really glamorous work. It's, you know, it's construction work. You're out there in the sun, especially in Las Vegas. It's 115 degrees sometimes. And started noticing my nose started getting really sunburned and red a lot. You know, I tried to keep the sun off of it with sunscreen, but over the years, it just progressively got worse. It's like, my nose is red all the time. I started going to dermatologists and stuff, and they would tell me, okay, well, you have rosacea. They would give me antibiotics to help me. Yeah, it helped a little bit, but it just nothing really made it go away. I would say about 10 years ago, it started really getting a lot of scar tissue. The width of my nose has gotten wider, and it seems to be infected a lot. Yeah, the scar tissue's built up to where it's just gotten really thick and kind of rubbery, kind of like a fake nose. My nostrils have closed off quite a bit from the scar tissue. I guess you can see it here. It kind of, I try to breathe through my nose and the air passages aren't as large as they should be normally. Your nose is a focal point of your face, you know? It's the first thing, if you got a bad nose like I have, people notice it right off.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
Pretty
good. You are Mr. Runyon. Nice to see you.
Nice
to meet you too. You have rhinophyma. Do you did you know that? Did you have that diagnosis
before? Yeah, I know
before?
That's what I have.
Yeah. How long have you had this?
Well, my nose started turning red, you know, with rosacea probably 15 years ago.
Okay, rosacea is a really common condition that occurs. The rarer form of it is what you have, which is rhinophyma. Rhinophyma happens more in men than women. And it happens predominantly on the nose, but it causes a thickening of your skin.
I know I have a pretty serious case. I mean, do you feel like you can get a lot of this roughness?
Well, let me take a look at you here first. Can you take your glasses off for me? Patrick has a very severe form of rhinophyma. In fact, it is the most advanced case that I've ever seen. So before I can be sure that I can treat him, I need to take a really good look. You can see how your nostrils are pretty normal here, and then it just changes right here, kind of causing them to close down a little bit, huh? I mean, it's virtually closed. The weight of this is like weighing down on you.
Everybody asks me if I can breathe. I think I can breathe, but
yeah,
it's probably
you can,
not.
But I bet you.
It's not as good.
Yeah, I bet you when you remove that, you're gonna be like, wow, now I can breathe. I think that I can do something to make this better for you. But I think I saw on your chart you're on a blood thinner.
Yeah.
Were you able to stop it? Somewhat?
I haven't stopped it, but I went to a half a dose.
This is an unexpected problem. My staff routinely calls my patients before any visits or any procedures that we're doing to make sure that they're prepared. And my staff told Patrick to please stop his blood thinners. But for some reason, he decided to just decrease the dose to half, and that's really not good enough. I'm worried about the fact that if we treat this entire nose, it will just bleed and bleed and not stop. Okay, so I had to go out and think about you for a little bit here.
Uh-huh.
Let me try to do this in a conservative and in a safe way. I'm gonna try to numb up an area around your nostrils and try to take off some of that and see how well you heal and how well that skin looks afterwards.
So you're saying you just want to do a little bit right now?
I'm saying to control a smaller little area, like the side of your nostril, on one side is more reasonable, and it's the safer way. But we got to do this right.
Yeah, oh yeah, okay.
And safely, okay?
All right.
All right, so hold on, we'll get started now, okay? It's ready. Essentially, it's like a hot knife that's cutting through butter. So what I'm gonna try to do is really sculpt this part of your nose. You can see all the whiteheads. I mean, if you squeeze on the squeeze out, that's like whiteheads there. chunks of oil. She's got all the sebum stuck in here, like just stuck in there. See how it is doing with bleeding? It's doing all right now. One of the most interesting parts about Rhinophyma is, you know, it's this thickened, really oily skin. So a lot of the times while you are taking some of that down, you will unearth little pockets of oil or fat. It almost looks like little pockets of chipped butter. Got a good amount of oil under there that is wanting to They're like little pockets of little just oil and sebum, like it's all just been, you know, collecting in there.
Yeah.
That's not unusual. It's just, I want to make sure it doesn't, I don't confuse that for your actual nose. You want to sculpt it down and still have your nose be nice and smooth contour. Turn that off for just a moment. Please. I'm just debating as to whether, what do I do here? You're not really bleeding, but I'm afraid about you bleeding later. Let me do a little on the other side, and then let me see what goes on, okay?
Okay.
At least we can open up those nostrils here. See, look, that right there, this is real nostril right here. Look, his real nostril has been pushed like this, smooshed down. What I'm gonna do to try to keep this symmetric too, because this side is fuller, is I'm gonna try to take down this here and try to release that nostril. I'm seeing it all come off. Isn't that amazing? It's like, I don't want to stop with you. I want to do this forever. I want to get it all down, but I just don't think it's safe. Turn that off again. So I've debulked both nostrils at this point, and I've decided to stop now. The numbing medicine temporarily constricts the blood vessels and minimizes bleeding. But if you're on a blood thinner, when the numbing medicine wears off, you may bleed later. And so this is something, I don't want to get a call at 3 a.m. with poor Patrick holding a bloody napkin on his face saying he can't control his bleeding nose. I mean, that's a little bit of a nightmare.
Look at that, you got quite a bit. You got nostrils again.
I can't do something and then regret it because we're not doing it the proper way.
Right.
You know what I mean?
I'd like to do the whole thing right now, but we don't want to take no chances.
We're not going to do it halfway, I promise you. That's not going to happen, no matter what. It's been 2 weeks since Patrick's last procedure, and I'm really excited to see what he looks like.
How are you? How are you doing?
I'm doing great.
Did you miss me?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah? Your nose missed me, huh?
I spoke to Patrick's doctor, and we got permission for Patrick to stop his blood thinners, so I'm really excited to finish what we started.
The thought crossed my mind that Dr. Lee wouldn't be able to finish the procedure, but yeah, I just decided to stay positive and move forward.
This is looking really good. I'm very excited about this.
It is a very odd sensation having the skin on my nose melted off.
I'm glad I didn't do the whole nose at one time. That would have taken me forever. When I removed the skin with this wire loop, we flaked off all these little pieces of skin and they look like bacon bits. Didn't smell like bacon bits, but they look like bacon. Whew. I think we're done.
Right now, I just gotta believe that this was all worth it, all the pain and the traveling and going through everything. And a month from now, I'm sure it's gonna be okay. Now that the Rhinophyma is gone, I feel more outgoing. This is a small town I live in. And I've had several people come up to me and say, man, that really looks good.